but it's few and far between, you know, like not most men are not men like that. So.
Right. But again, we got to look at the pattern, and the pattern is that those men you're describing are raised by single women. Right. So there's no way.
No, I mean, this guy wasn't, dude. He's a freaking trust fund kid. He wears like $500 shell cardigan leather shoes. He's fucking psycho. He's like literally an American psycho. He's like white, hoity-toity, has everything, millionaire parents that have been together his whole life, and is just crazy.
You got a whole bunch of unhealthy people, and it doesn't. The blame isn't the. You know, the blame doesn't just lay on one side of the table, because you got damaged people on both sides of the table, be it the man or the woman. I've seen and experienced enough of two parents in the house, a lot of abuse going on. I mean, I've seen a lot of stuff. It's not just
me personally. I was raised by my
society is out of whack as a whole.
He probably saw his father beat his mother. He learned that behavior from somewhere. Most people that's abusive, that didn't just rise up in a vacuum. That came from somewhere. Oh,
I agree for sure, but I have no way of really knowing like what or why.
So also, we seem to agree that, you know, nobody's directly to blame besides the system that's in place, right? But if that's the case, then again, we must look at the pattern or what is being taught to us through the system in order to really seek out the issue.
Right.
And if we do that, then we would come to the conclusion that most of these thoughts that are transpiring, right, from women in general, are thoughts that are being instilled by the system.
Who's so ran by men.
Right. Who have the same mission of keeping us
to
apart.
Destroy the family.
Simply.
They have a mission to destroy the nuclear family.
And why do you think that is? Because family units, the nuclear family unit, has the power to overthrow and build countries, revolutionize worlds, right? This all societies are ran by, you know, powerful families that work in the back end, you know, that own everything, right? But nobody wants to think about that. So why are we not working to build a strong nuclear family and expand so that we don't have to, you know, be subject to the system and the thoughts that they instill in us that is clearly creating discrepancies between us?
Jerry, just do it. What you got, man? You should just let me in. Jerry, just do it. What you got, man? We're going up on 5 hours now, man.
Nah. I was just like, because it's a lot of like contradiction from on the female side more so, because it's like we're trying to compare if we're 50-50, because a woman can have a child is not equal. And then on top of that, it's like, I don't know. It's just a lot of biasness. It's like, let's just all be real. And let's all not try to make different things up to make us seem right, because everybody can be right or wrong. But to say that men and women are equal is kind of like, it's a contradiction, because even the house you live in is built by men. And not even to measure that, women have a big place in the world. So we're not saying that we're not 50-50 and you're less of a woman or anything like that. We're saying that it's not 50-50. Like, a man is not built the same as a woman. So you having a baby or being able to have a baby comes from a man too, right? So you gotta exclude that from the conversation to start.
Not really. When I say that we are equal, I'm talking about the survival of us as a whole depends on each other. And so, yes, I did not deny that we are different physically, but we had to be different physically. Otherwise, it would be, you know what that would be. Right. It would either we be lesbian or men. Men are gay. I mean, come on. I'm not talking about from that perspective. But to sit, I mean, look, everybody have their thing.
No, I'm just saying. I'm not saying you're wrong. But I'm saying, like,
and I'm not.
I'm saying to say that men and women are equal, and then to say, what you just said just now, how is that equal? I'm just trying to figure out how do you think that is
okay,
equal.
So I say like this, if you was to remove woman from society, let's see what would happen to man.
Men would still live and thrive, but there would be no more recreation.
If you was to remove, and vice versa, if you was to get rid of the men, how would woman survive?
So what would be your reason to have a man as a husband or whatever the case may be? What would be your reason?
What would be the reason to have somebody? You get, well, I don't know why anybody else does get into a relationship. First of all, I believe in a monogamous relationship. I like one-on-one. I don't want to be in a situation where I got to be sharing somebody something.
Each his own.
That to me is not, that's a whole village right there.
That's your opinion though.
No, it's not my opinion. That's my personal preference.
Right. That's your opinion.
No, it's not my opinion.
I can find a female right now that does not think the way you think.
No.
It's the opposite of what you're saying.
No, I did not say nobody else didn't want that. I said, that's my personal preference.
Right. That's my personal opinion.
Preference. No, it's not my opinion. It's my way of life. It's my preference.
Right.
Each of y'all have your own preferences, and that's fine. Nobody's trying to take that away from anyone. But what I'm saying is you can't bash the woman and say, well, you're this, you're that.
No, what they're saying is a woman has an innie, right? And a man has an outie. Hold on, let me finish.
I understand that.
Before you get combative, let me finish. A woman has an innie. A man has an outie. So that means every time you have sexual relations with a man, you're getting his energy and you're getting him. So for a woman to go and sleep with this guy, this guy, this guy, this guy, this guy in the same week, you just got all of those different men energy, right? Compared to a man, hold on, let me finish. Wait. Compared to a man who has a Audi and can go around and sleep with this girl, that girl, it's not the same. It's not the same.
In your eyes, it's not the same. In my eyes, what's the difference? It's all dirty. It's nasty.
So you mean I don't know what man in the world will want a woman.
But that's my personal preference. That shit is nasty. No, there's no way you can't tell me it is. And diseases and stuff is spreaded. You're swapping body fluids, nevertheless. Nevertheless, this is how disease and stuff is spread it when you're doing things like that.
We're not talking about diseases, though. We're not talking about that.
You're talking about somebody just running around and just sleeping with people.
I'm saying a woman has it any. So you women feel, right? Women feel. So when you have sexual relations with a man, you feel, right? You have energy and you believe in crystals and everything like that, right? So there's energy transferring, right?
I know what you're saying is correct as far as energy, which energy is energy. Energy is energy. Energy is energy. So if either way, energy is being exchanged.
Come on, let him make his point, man.
it's like you're rather say anything to try to be right when I'm not saying you're wrong at all. I'm just saying open your mind. Or just open your mind.
My mind is open.
And the whole conversation, you've been defensive and you have not opened your mind about anything. You've been reaching so far to find something so that way you can be right when it's not about being right or wrong. It's about opening your mind and maybe thinking that what you were taught to believe may not be the end all be all. Because it's not, if you look in society nowadays, right?
Oh my God.
That means you're telling me that a person can't, it just don't make sense. Because what you're saying is
you can do what you want. It's your body. You can do what you want. It's
right.
Your body.
Exactly. So you can do what you want with your body. So because you choose to do what you want with your body does not make it the end all be all.
Excuse me. Let me tell you something. I've been celibate for a very long time, several times in my life. So no, I don't go out there and throw myself around like that. I value myself. But if you're going to sit here and say, y'all gonna sit there and say, oh, it's okay for a man to do it. In my eyes, it's not okay for a man to do it. It's not okay for a woman to do it. However, people do what they want to do. It doesn't matter. It's no skin off my back.
Right. So let me ask you a question. So because you see the world in your eyes, in one way, in your eyes, does that necessarily mean that that is right or wrong?
Listen, I'm asking my preference.
Right. Listen, it's my point. Hold on. Wait. Hold on. Right there. Wait. Stop right there. Stop right there. It's your preference, right? Meaning, it's if it's your preference, you can
look at anybody else. And not mean that it does not mean it's right. Like Sharon on him. Man.
Two people. That's my idea of a relationship.
This is why I like one man, one woman. She always comes with the energy, man. I gotta give her that. Who them?
No doubt. Jerry.
Hey, Sharon, I can't hold you, Sharon. This is what I like you on.
Don't get upset. But like I'm saying,
this is what I like to get you on.
Outlook. Your outlook.
Do I look upset? Do I look upset?
You do.
I'm not upset.
You do.
No, I don't.
You're trying to make a big smile, make it seem like you're not upset, but you are bothered.
You are bored and bothered.
And I've been in this thing the whole time, and I just couldn't take it no more. I just had to say it because it's like you're saying that you're fine, but you are bothered. Look at your. Your facial expressions tells it. Everything tells it. Because whenever these guys were saying,
pause for station identification.
Making up something to make it seem like you know your outlook on life is the right way, and it should only be this way. When it's like a human, just like I'm a human, and it's like we all have different opinions, but that doesn't mean that if your outlook on life is the same. It ain't. It doesn't mean you're right at all, and you contradict yourself.
No. I'm saying it's a contradiction to me, and you could condemn woman for doing it, but you don't condemn man.
It's double standard. We're not the same.
You can't, it's a double standard.
Right. We're not the same. There is double standards in the world. There is double standards in the world, and that's just it. You can't make something up because you want to make it up. A woman that runs around and have sex with 30, 40, 50 men is looked at like a beep. And then a man. Stop cutting me off. If she's doing that,
do you think she cares? If she's doing that, she don't care. She probably
But the outlook on life.
Sharon, let him speak for a second. You've been spitboxing all night.
Right. It's like you're saying that the woman that's doing that, she doesn't look down on herself. Right. But the men, they do.
And how can he when dogs lay down with fleas, they both wake up with fleas. So how are you gonna look down on something you doing? Stop it.
What you mean? You're a woman, right?
Yes.
So if you get impregnated, if you get impregnated, right? Do you think that anybody in the world is gonna say, oh, no, it's cool. She can just go sleep with a bunch of other men still and do whatever she want to do, and everybody's just fine with it.
What these gentlemen were saying was, don't act like we don't look down on men who already got a woman pregnant and he's still sleeping around and he's coming back.
But then, all right, now look, let's bring it back to that.
And he's been out in the street sleeping with other women. He gonna bring that dirty penis back and
he's messing with a clean woman.
Now, why it gotta be dirty? That's the thing. That's my point. You make up things to your scenario so you can win. But it's like if a man got four women pregnant, right, and a man can handle all four women and raise his kids and be in his kids' life like Nick Cannon, what's the problem?
What's the problem if a woman do it? What's the problem?
You can't have more than one baby at a time. The thing.
It don't matter. There was one woman who had twins, and both them babies had different daddies. I don't believe in living like that for the man, and I don't believe in living like that for the woman.
She looked down on.
Okay.
You're old school, and you believe in these old things that's been around for all of these years. It's not right. Like they tell you to work a job for 65 years, right? They tell you to work a job for 65 years and then retire and live off your retirement, right? If you work till you 65 years old nowadays and you try to live off your retirement, you won't even get past the year. So how are you still living by the same standards that was put on us and enslaved on us for years and years and years? But we still not winning.
Listen, I have no recollection of that mess that was going on before. I only know what I know right now.
You're living off of the belief.
I know what I know right now. A running around man. The Bible speaks on both a harsh man and a woman.
We are not talking about the Bible.
So don't sit here and try to make it seem like it's okay for a man to be a whore, but it ain't okay for a woman to be a whore. It's not okay for either one of them.
That's the real thing in life. That's the thing. You're lying to yourself. You are lying to myself.
Men are horse bad.
Then y'all said more men cheat than women. More women cheat than men.
How?
And women are better at it.
Better mentality.
Women are better at it.
Listen,
that's pulling.
Maybe because women might
My child's mother was sleeping around with other men, and she was hiding the shit out of it. Because she was so good at it. I mean, I knew, I just never said nothing, but she thought that she was so good at it that she was winning until she found out the grass wasn't greener on the other side, and now she's sleeping in her mom's basement. So don't sit here. Hold on, wait. Let me finish. And don't sit here and tell me that the world is in favor of men, because when I go to court, it don't seem that way.
Facts.
I'm trying to get my child where I live in a house by myself with three or four rooms, right? That I can provide for my child. I can give my child anything in the world she wants. But the court system let her go with her mother in her mother's basement of her own mom's house. That's freezing down there. So don't tell me you can't. Come on now. I live this real life thing. So it's like if you're going to be biased towards one side, don't do it. Like, let's just be real.
I never said that. And I did say, if you take the cotton out your ears, I said that in some arenas, no, the system is not fair towards men, and it does lean more towards the woman.
But it's random.
Well, we're talking about whoredom right about now. Okay, it's not right. It's disrespectful for a woman to disrespect her body like that, but it's also disrespectful for a man to disrespect his body.
It's his nature, Siobhan. It's his nature.
In your eyes.
But why do you think so many men coming on here making this point, Siobhan?
And then you're talking about animals. If you look at nature, have you looked at nature and see how animals do things? Because if you sitting there
but
saying,
but you're not an animal, you have intellect.
You made that comparison. You made the comparison.
Excuse me, we're not.
You don't
animals.
Even remember what you're saying.
Men are greedy.
You don't even know what you're saying anymore.
When it comes down, look, if you got a beautiful woman by your side, she supported, she did, she
turned
that.
Up again,
why
huh?
do you need 15 other women? For what?
No, that's an exaggeration. We didn't say 15.
Your own vitality.
Right. There's men out here who have three wives, and all three wives are, listen, before you talk, just listen. There's men out here who have multiple wives, and all their wives are valuable to that man, and all of them three women, they are for it, and they're thriving with their family. So you can't sit there and say, because it takes a village to raise a child, right? It takes a village to raise a child. So if that's the case, who's to say that men have to have just one woman? But y'all call us dogs, though.
Wait a minute.
Right.
Listen, it can make sense. If you want five or six women, bravo. Bravo.
My point. So you are
good for you. I'm talking about whoredom.
But that's not just whoredom, though.
Define that word. Define that word.
I'm talking about whoredom. Y'all talking about, oh, these women consent to a marriage. That's not the same as whoredom.
See what I'm saying?
That's
you making up things so that way you can be right.
That's not about being right or wrong.
It's about being honest.
Wait a minute. When somebody is in agreement to something,
can you say accountability?
Someone is in agreement to something, right? When somebody is in agreement to something, then they signed on for that. These women signed on to be sister wives. There are a lot of relationships that are supposed to be monogamous that are not monogamous, and that man is out there sleeping with this person. What I'm saying is that behavior is no better than the behavior of a woman who you think is loyal to you. Because lies is lies. To me, it is the same thing.
You keep trying to compare a man and a woman, right? You cannot compare a man and a woman. A woman has an innie, a man has an outie.
This is
two different things.
This is the reason it does not matter. It doesn't matter that a woman got to
feel with emotion.
That doesn't mean
that woman's not going to feel some kind of way.
Wow. Listen, a lie is a lie. Okay, I'm not a lie.
Let the electrical bills go down. We'll see if we equal.
Yeah, who would have treated you, Brother Ben?
I'm not,
5 hours
listen,
and six
I'm
minutes.
Not lying. I'm not lying to myself. Man. There are relationships where it's just one-on-one relationships.
I had no clue this was going to last this long.
No, you're trying to convince every woman to want to be a sister.
No, we're not.
Right?
No, we're not. Nobody, nobody's trying to convince any woman.
What keeps going through my mind is if electrical bills go down, will she still be equal?
He wants to be a one-woman.
Why not open your mind and not be defensive?
That's the problem. My eyes are open.
They are. They're not.
My
them things are closed. Them things are all the way closed.
My eyes are wide open.
Dude,
my eyes are wide open.
What's that?
My eyes are open.
Now, one person on here has said, hey, we need to change your mind and make you think that every woman should have more than one man. Nobody said that. Nobody said that.
My eyes are open. My eyes are open.
Okay, so they're open, right?
Heavy, baby. Heavy.
Forget it. Listen, you already know when you bring me on here, it's never going to be no, I'm agree, because I don't.
Listen,
I don't agree.
If there was a female on here, right? If there was a female on here that was talking with like that was talking with real logic and not trying to make things up to for them to seem right, then
nobody made things up. I can call a female right now
that will make that will contradict everything you're saying and make you seem like that you are only one sided. You are only one sided.
No, y'all one sided. Y'all one sided.
Was it not you?
Delusional.
But who don't? Sharon. Alicia was pretty much agreeing with everything we were saying.
Right.
Who? Good Alicia. For her. That's her.
But so and how you turn on one side
look,
then?
She probably want one of y'all anyway. Who
but
cares?
She's a female.
So I got to pitch her up here. So
and that's what you got to do. You don't even know her.
Because she's been taught. Listen, do you think I came from parents who didn't say, well, men and women are different. And you think I came from parents that didn't think that? But I am saying to you, if my father would have been out there cheating, that would have been a whole together. That household would not have stood up.
Now you just made an accusatory statement, man.
That's false. That's false.
You create beef with everyone on the call, Sharon.
I ain't creating no beef with nobody.
I know a man who cheated on his woman.
You're fighting the wrong war, sister. The wrong war.
You
going against the man. When a man is trying to put you down, a man is trying to put you game. We're just trying to put you game with real life and real society and the way the world really works. You're living in a bubble. You're living in a bubble.
Sharon, you know what I think you need to do, Sharon? I think you need to go to Gaza for a minute.
Gaza.
I think you need to go to Gaza for a minute. Your whole mindset was
that. Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah, right.
And don't y'all gonna defend hold on.
Y'all
look,
quarter.
Look,
go ahead.
Just to retouch on base. We are full, like I don't have no problem with you. You know what I'm saying? Like I don't have a problem with you. There's nothing that I'm trying to. I don't have nothing against you because I don't really know you, right? So it's like I'm not saying these things to get at you or to make you angry as a woman or anything like that. I'm saying this as a man. Hold on, wait. I'm saying this as a man that's trying to open a woman's mind and get them to understand that everything is not the way you have in your head. That's all. Right. But wait.
That's okay.
So it's like, so why are you so emotional and why are you so offended about what men are telling you?
Excuse me. Listen, I'm not offended. That's just not my way. That's not my way.
So are you, it's not your way, right?
Which no, is absolutely
1,000% fine. But are you saying that it's wrong?
What did I say that is wrong? Look. If it ain't wrong for a man to do
no, see,
it.
Now you're making
that's
up other things. No, I asked the question. Is it wrong?
And I gave you my answer.
Is it wrong?
I gave you my answer.
Is it wrong?
Listen.
Yes or no? Yes or no?
If you condemn a woman for doing it and don't condemn a man for doing it, answer your own question. Answer your own question. If it's wrong for a woman to do it, why isn't it wrong for a man to do it? Just
because
that's his nature, though.
You have it in
you. It don't got nothing to do with that.
You carry a child.
If a person's nature is
you carry
just,
a child. Don't
they
you?
Don't have no
don't
soul,
you carry
no
a child?
Control, then that person don't have
you
no
don't
self
see
control.
Animals running around here. You
Yo,
pregnant.
I appreciate you having me on the platform, brother. I'm a slide, but yeah. You see what it is.
You're going to defend your own lower nature. Of course you're going to defend it.